When you're working in film, video, or audio production, you're going to encounter lots of different sound sources. In order to record them properly, you're going to want to learn the difference between the different types of signal levels produced by different types of equipment, so you don't damage your gear and you're able to properly record sound for your projects. By the time this video is done, I'll give you a detailed explanation of four different audio signal levels that you'll come across when using various audio gear. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a videography, photography, and technology guru, but you can call me a dadographer. I've created many other videos on improving your photography, videography, filmmaking, video editing, audio recording, and technology skills. I'll link to those in the description below and both during and at the end of this video, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week, and I'll be uploading many more explanations of film, video, photo editing, and technology topics. Stay tuned till the end to find out how to get my absolutely free DSLR, mirrorless, or interchangeable lens video camera cheat sheet that'll have you shooting photos and videos like a pro in no time. In the audio world, there are four signal levels that we deal with. They are mic, line, instrument, and speaker. These levels all have different meanings, so it's important to know the differences between them. Now, this video is going to give you a basic introduction, but I'm not going to go into super detail about how they all work. That's a video for another time. The two most common signal levels that you'll encounter in film and video making will be mic level and line level. So we're going to start with that. Number one is mic level signal. Both mic and line level audio refer to the voltage level of an audio signal. Wired and wireless microphones are typically connected to mic level inputs, while most other audio devices, such as mixers and the outputs of mic preamps, use line level signals. The voltage of each type of signal varies significantly, making it important to know how they differ. Microphone level signals describe the voltage generated by a microphone when it picks up sound, typically just a few thousandths of a volt. That's 1/1,000. This voltage varies in response to changes in sound level and the distance of the audio source away from the mic. Of the four main types of audio signals, microphone level is the weakest and requires a preamp to bring it up to line level. Microphone level is usually specified between -60 and -40 dBU. Several different types of devices are used to boost microphone levels to line level. Mixers are probably the most popular piece of equipment, since they can also combine multiple signals together into a single output. Preamplifiers and mic-to-line amplifiers also do the job just as well, and are available as single-channel or multi-channel devices, so you can put more than one microphone into it. If you want to learn more about the different types of microphones out there, check out the video I did on microphones. I'll put a link to that video in the description below, and you can click up here and see it as well. Number two on our list of audio sources that you'll encounter is line level. A line level signal is about 1 volt, or about 1,000 times as strong as a mic level signal. The two signal types do not ordinarily use the same inputs. This signal travels from your preamplifier to the amplifier. There are two standard line levels, +4 dBU for professional equipment like mixing desks and signal processing gear, and -10 dBU for consumer equipment such as smartphone headphone jacks. The other two types of audio signals are instrument level and speaker level. So let's do number three now, which are instrument level. Like mic level signals, instrument level signals, such as an electric guitar or bass guitar or whatever, require pre-amplification to bring them up to line level. Instrument level signals fall in between mic level at the low end and line level at the higher end signals. It's in the middle there. These signals refer to any level put out by any kind of instrument. Finally, the fourth signal that you'll come up with is speaker level. After line level signals enter an amplifier, it exits to the speakers at what is called speaker level. Post-amplification speaker level signals are even higher in voltage than line level and require speaker cables for safe signal transfer. It's critical to match a device to the correct input since there is no technical tolerance for any mistakes. Otherwise, you know, the whole audio system fails. For example, connecting a microphone to a line level input will result in almost no sound at all since the mic level signal is too weak to drive the line level input. Conversely, connecting a line level source to a mic level input will cause the sound to be loud and very distorted because the line level signal is so much stronger than what the mic input will accept. A mic level input is typically a female XLR connector, while a line level input can be an RCA jack, a quarter inch connector, or a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. Instrument level connectors are most often quarter inch connectors, and speaker level connections use various different types of speaker connections. Once you do audio long enough, you'll get familiar with these different types of connectors. Now, if all this is making sense to you, but I've got it in the comments section below. My question of the day is, have you ever encountered audio issues? If you have, what were they and how did you fix them? Leave a comment below and let us know. Would you like to learn more about your camera settings to get you shooting like a pro? I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings for your DSLR, mirrorless, or video camera that will show you the settings that will allow your photos and videos that you shoot with those cameras to compete with the pros. If you're shooting your video or film, you can even put the audio tips in this video to good use by using that sheet as well. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. I've also created cheat sheets on other topics such as video editing and even now offer training courses on editing video using Adobe Premiere Pro, and soon I'll have others. The link to those cheat sheets and training courses is in the description below as well. You want to see more videos like this? Follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, for more. Think what you saw was great? Like it. Do you have an opinion? Comment below. Know someone who could benefit from the information I provided? Please share the video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Costa Films on social media and online on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web. I currently have over 4,300 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of the other videos that I've done for great tips and suggestions. If you follow me for a while now, you know that I have a community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers just like you on Facebook where I share pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work and learn from others, but also help others as well. You'll find a link to that group in the description below. Feel free to join in, where you'll learn much, much more.